I'm Pascual, 11 years old, primary 5, also from Emin Primary School.
So for this lesson, vocabulary and
techniques of definite integral.
So this is the first lesson, which is the
Gamma function.
So the last few, in the past, we learned three other methods, which is the reduction, the symmetric
property of the integrand
and
the corresponding integrand.
Okay, so now we are at the fourth method, which is the gamma function, right?
Yes.
So now,
for these two, it doesn't look like using the gamma function. But why? We still need to use the gamma function.
Okay, let me just say, over here, for the first question, you need to, both of the questions, you need to use substitution.
You mean using substitution to change it into the gamma function?
Yes. Even though you may be thinking, wait, they are improper, we can't solve it. Look, ln 0, infinity, denominator.
No, ln 0 is negative infinity.
Ln 0, negative infinity. Then there's another negative. Then become denominator infinity. And here 1, ln 1, 0, denominator 0, the whole thing becomes infinity. It's improper. So, and the second question, until infinity, improper again. And plus, this time it's special. This time it's just a single integral.
So can you try for the first question?
Okay. So explain. Okay? Okay? And don't forget to...
For the first, you need to integrate from 0 to infinity. Dx over square root negative ln x.
Something like this. Okay, so what should we let? Okay, so we'll let negative ln x equals to u, okay?
Can.
So over here, which dx will equals to, do you know how much du?
First, when you differentiate this part, you have an extra negative 1 over x.
Yes.
And x is, first move the negative. That means ln x is a negative u. So x is e to the power of negative u.
Like this.
Weight is, okay.
Then now for the rate. So let's sum. If it was 0, negative infinity.
But there's another negative.
We make it infinity and we'll change it to 0 to infinity, okay? Could we?
So that is infinity to 0, but if you just put the extra negative inside, then it will be 0 to infinity.
Okay. And now we'll sub it in. Would we have an extra negative?
No, we don't have an extra negative. We use this negative to change these two boundaries.
Yes. So here, square root, denominator becomes square root u, then numerator, or the e to the power of
negative u,
then here du. I noticed something. Do you notice?
Continue.
Do you notice something? I'm asking you.
It becomes the gamma function.
Yes. Wait, there's something like in the black and white did?
Because this is to the power of negative half. You add one, becomes half. In the last lesson, we found out what is this, right?
Yeah, so we could just sub it in. And could you write it down what is it?
That is the square root pi.
Okay, so...
Yup, you wrote it there.
What I mean that is you write it here so later in case still have the same thing. Okay?
Okay. So at first, you might think this is impossible to integrate. But after
you make
substitution...
Wait, at first you may think it's so impossible. You can't use factorization. You can't use any other three methods. You can't use partial fraction. You can't use so much things.
But you can use substitution.
Yes.
So next, can we have our second question?
Okay. So the second question, what is the integral from 0 to infinity square root x times e to the power of negative x cubed dx? Wait, let me ask you. Here, 0 to infinity improper, right? But something fishy going on here. But over there is not a negative x, there is a negative x cubed.
So we'll need to use substitution to change it.
Again?
Yeah.
So actually we'll let x cube to be u and y will x be write it down. So dx equals to 1 over...
And when you differentiate this part, you have a 3x squared, right?
Yes, will become 1 over 3u to the power of... Okay, you can just write it as u to the power of 3 over 2, okay?
2 over 3.
I mean 2 over 3.
Okay, like that also can.
And then, why use frame? Let's sub. 0? Yes, 0 to infinity still. Ta-da!
Can we put the 1/3 outside?
Yes, of course.
What happens to the square root x?
Wait, but I thought it would be more complicated. What are you thinking about? A secret plan again? Or does you mean timing them together?
We can combine these two together.
Okay.
So but does it seem right? Did you know that there's something not right here? Did you realize that?
Okay.
Because you divide it to the other side.
Oh, yes. But what are you thinking of? I don't think it's right.
So at this part, it's a 1 over 6. Here is a negative 2 over 3. So when you put these two together...
Negative half? Wait a second! I noticed something fishy. Look. Over here.
So you just saw this in again?
Yes, it just say I have an extra coefficient.
So this. Isn't it weird that you can change their forms?
Yes. At first, a lot of things we can do, but then after substitution, but not direct. After substitution, whoa, everything can do.
So these are what we call it, applications of the gamma function.
Yes. At first, you may think it's impossible, right?
Why do we call them applications?
Why?
Because for this, we need to use the gamma function for this. Definite integrations. Right?
Yeah.
So far for this lesson, are you clear?
Okay. So next time we'll continue, okay?
Okay, these questions, they might be weird, but when there's a will, there's a way.
Yes, and of course, you must think about a way. One way cannot use another method, they keep on using it until you found it.
So is there any other questions?
Nope. So this will be the end for this time, and if you like our video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So it will be to be continued, okay?
Stay tuned for more videos.
Okay.
Thank you for your watching.